Welcome, friends. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. Today we're going to do another cocktail out of this little book that we've used before. It is called Cocktails, simply Cocktails. It is by Jimmy, late of Ciro's in London, and this was published in 1930. This copy was published in Toronto, but it was published at the same time in the United States. So there are copies of both floating around, and this is in the middle of Prohibition. And this book, we've talked about this before, it starts using something called parts instead of ounces or jiggers. It sort of codifies the measurements in the book to make it easier. Everything's a ratio. And, you know, the author says that at the beginning that these ratios are so easy that even a five-year-old could make the drinks without asking daddy what size is a jigger. And the one we're going to do today, I don't think a five-year-old should necessarily be drinking. It's called the Canvasback. So we start out with three parts of Scotch whiskey, and I'm going to use this Dewar's. So there's one and a half. Oh no. Three. Then we have two parts Italian vermouth. One part dry gin. Two parts lemon juice. This is even going to be big for two cocktails. Now it says 5 dashes of Curacao per cocktail. I'm making 2 cocktails, so that's 10 dashes. I don't really know how much a dash is. Nobody does. So I'm going to say 2 bar spoons of Curacao is going to get us there. And then 10 dashes of Angostura. Seems like a lot. Now, we ice this off. And give it a shake. Now, got a couple of cocktail glasses iced. And we'll double strain. The Canvasback.
Hey, Glenn. Hey, friends. That's a really big drink.
It is a really big drink. So, it's in parts. And just to make it easy on myself, I said a part was an ounce.
That does make the math easy.
It makes the math easy. And so I thought I'll just make 2 cocktails, make them exactly the same, use parts as an ounce. There's a whole section of toasts in the back of this book.
What? I think we've read them before.
None of them are appropriate.
No.
So.
That's what I remember about them.
None of them are appropriate. So
that, yes, the 2 things I remember about this book is, one, apparently your five-year-old can mix your drinks, and yep. 2, completely inappropriate toasts.
So, let's give the canvas back a try.
That has a lot of flavor in it.
Oh, there's so many flavors fighting for the top, isn't there? Okay, so I get smoky from the scotch that we used. Definitely you can taste the scotch. It's got that high note. I get the lemon.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely get the lemon.
And then the orange lemon combo.
Yeah, the Curacao is in there a little bit. The gin is, I think, completely lost to me.
I can't decide if I'm fond of it or not.
No, but I want to take another drink.
I know. That's the thing. That's the part that's confusing, right? It's like, it's interesting. And I feel like a slight tweak would make it really great. And what that is,
I'm not sure either. But
for my palate.
But it's interesting enough that you want to taste it again to say, what is it about this that's interesting?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the Canvasback from 1930. I don't know. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.